You are attending computer coding class.
Welcome. Today we will learn how to create menus and submenus in tkinter form. Let's start coding. Here I am using spider as an editor. First of all, we will import tkinter as tk. Here I will create an invoice manager form. Second import is message box for displaying any type of message. Now we will create the object of our tkinter package. Its name is root. Now we will declare the name of our form by using title function. Next we will set the size of our form, that is called geometry. Its width is 400 and height is 300, and root.mainloop is used to run our form. First of all, we will create our top level menu by using command menu tk.menu, and then we configure it. Now we will create our first menu, that is file menu. Now second argument in our menu function is tier off. By default it is 1. We set tier off equal to 0. It means it will not work as a floating menu. Now we will set the name of our first menu, that is file menu, and we set its name as file. Now we will create submenus in our top level menu file. We will create 3 submenu. First one is new, second one is open, and third one is save. Here we will use add command function. First we will set its name by using label argument, and second one is command. Here we are not adding any function in command, we are just writing none. You can create any procedure or function and add that procedure name here. So whenever anyone click on that menu, that function will be run. These are 3 our first sub menu in top menu file. Now we will add a separator. Separator means a line. And last sub menu is our exit menu for exiting from this form, closing this form. Here we will use command root.destroy, that will destroy the form and release the memory. This is the separator and exit button, and when we click on exit button, it just destroy the form. This is our first top level menu, that is the file menu and its sub menus. Now I will create another top level menu, that's name is calculate, and in this top level menu I will create so many sub menus for calculation purpose. First menu's name is calc menu. Now I will set its name by using command add underscore cascade. Its name is calculate. Now in this menu I will create different sub menu. Our first sub menu is interest. Its name is int sub menu. Its top menu is calc menu, and int sub menu is the sub menu under top menu calc menu. Now I will set the name of our first sub menu, that is interest. This is the second level of menu. Now run the program. This is second top menu and interest is the sub menu of our top menu, calculate. Now I will add third level sub menu under our second sub menu, that is the interest. It means top level menu is calculate, first sub menu is interest, and under that interest I will create third level menu. Here first menu is simple interest and second one is compound interest. In this way we created three level menus. Here I am setting command equal to none. Command is used to run any function, procedure or event. Now run the program. This is a form. You can see here all three menus. First one is calculate, second one is interest, and third one is simple interest and compound interest. Now I am creating another second level sub menu under our calculate top level menu. Its name is purchase. Now run the program. This is the second level of menu. Now I am creating third top level menu, that is the exit. To show you that without using any sub menu, by clicking on top level menu you can perform any task. Here I am doing exiting from the form by clicking on top level menu. Here all three sub menu and this is the top level exit menu. So it is not necessary to create sub menus. Directly you can perform action by using your top level menu. Now I am creating a small function CI. CI means compound interest. To show you that by clicking sub menu you can execute any function. Here I am not doing any calculation, I am just printing a message compound interest. You can create calculation also. Here I will connect this procedure with our compound interest sub menu. Now in place of none I will write just the name of our function CI. Here we need not add any type of parenthesis. This is our whole program. Now we will run the program. This is our first menu, simple interest, compound interest. When I click compound interest it is executing and showing our message. Thank you for watching this video.